pound for pound rankings. You know, a lot of people have him one or two, you know, depending on how you put Lomachenko in there. I mean, in my opinion, you should be right in the mix, but you don't really hear outside of, you know, the guys who are on this side that you're in, you know, that top three position. And I think you should be. How do you feel about that? Is that weighing your mind ever at all?
Man, it's good being in the pound for pound, but man, like I said, man, I don't really care, man. I'm a worker, man. I got my head down and I'm drilling away. So. And eventually, if they don't have me in there, they will have me pound for pound number one. So I'm not gonna argue with anybody and say, so I plead my case. No, we're gonna keep beating the fighters that's in front of me, keep beating the top five fighters. And then in the next 2 years, you don't have me, or a year, you don't have me in the pound for pound, then probably has something against me or my management or something.
Keith Thurman, as he's assumingly have no interest in fighting Jeff Horn over in Australia, would you consider that fight presented itself?
I mean,
in Australia though.
If Al come to me with it, I'm pretty sure that, you know, it's in my best interest, and you know, I would go to Australia if I present it to me. Money's right, you know, and everything, you know, a fair playing field where, you know, the judge and everything else and the referee and everything's cool, then I'll do it. But, I mean, Al never came to me with it, so I'm not worried about it. I got Lamont Peters in front of me. That's the guy I'm fighting. I think he's a way tougher fighter than Jeff Horn. I think Lamont could beat Jeff Horn. So, I mean, it is what it is. The fight presents itself, and my management come to me with the fight, and I accept, because I know my management is in my best interest. He's not going to come to me with no bull crap where, you know, trying to sell me out or trying to sell me short to have me go to Australia and just, you know, basically just lose me if I win.
EJ, if you don't want
to
comment,
I don't believe he's that big for me to go out, just to go to Australia to fight him for the, we got WBO or something?
Yeah.
Get a WBO title anyway, so.
EJ, if you don't want to answer, I understand, but Jerry Jones, I know you're a big fan of the Cowboys, said that he wants all the players to stand during the anthem.
Yeah.
Do you think that players like Zeke, that Dez, and the Stars should still kneel down, or maybe as a team they should all kneel down? What do you think about that?
I mean, it's all about, at the end of the day, you know, you got free speech, you got free will to do what you want. So if you don't want to kneel, they don't want to kneel down, they don't have to kneel down. But, you know, if they do, you know, great. You know, especially show a defiance to, you know, somebody who, you know, telling them not to do something. You know, I don't see how you can tell somebody that, but, I mean, if they don't want to kneel down, they don't have to kneel down. I don't see nothing wrong with it. They got freedom of speech and, you know, freedom to do what they want to. So, I mean, it is what it is. You know, some players, you know, they put food on the table by football. So a lot of guys logically, if I do this, you know, Jerry might get fined or I might get cut or something like that. And now I can't put food on my kid's table. So, I mean, a lot of guys not fortunate, like, you know, the top level guys where they can do that and they still have money in the bank to do this. You don't want to see a rookie kneel down. A rookie kneel down or a 7-round pick kneel down, you might not see him in the next game. So, and nobody's going to talk about him. So I can't say what a guy should or shouldn't do, because if he messed up, I'm not putting food on his table. I'm not feeding his family. I'm not doing this and that. So if you don't want to do it, that's cool. If you do it, kudos to you. But I'm not going to judge you either way.